I'm Miana Trafalis, and I work for the Athens Institute for Education and Research, which is a world association for academics and researchers. I'd like to welcome you to Athens Interview Series, where we interview the participants that attend our conferences. Today I'm going to be interviewing Dr. Vladimir Mako, who is a professor at the University of Belgrade in Serbia. Hello, welcome to Athens.
Thank you very much.
So can you give a brief academic introduction of yourself?
Yes, well, it was a long time ago when I finished my architectural studies at the University of Belgrade, at the faculty where I'm teaching now. And I obtained there also my master's in science. And I finished my doctorate of science at the faculty of philosophy at the same university. After that, I was working as a practicing architect for a few years, and from 1988, I'm working at the faculty. During that time, it's around next year, 30 years, I was working also as a visiting professor at other universities around Serbia, the region, the world. So that is, in short, my academic background.
So what is currently your major area of research?
In my early days in academia, I decided to make my efforts to research and to teach in aesthetics. Basically, I was involved in art and architecture, but I shifted from the historical papers into aesthetics, which allowed me to shift from contemporary issues to issues of historical periods. Actually, aesthetic allows to investigate ideas. Ideas, they can be used even in the contemporary context. And the ideas through which we can learn how people are thinking in different areas of art and architecture. Ideas are always alive, so aesthetics are giving us exactly that point. It is somehow the research of the continuity of ideas that developed through the whole history of mankind. And allowed also to shift into other cultures. We are living in a transcultural world, and it is very good to understand how people are thinking about architecture as a cultural and social communication. Aesthetics is about that. How to recognize that kind of communication.
So you presented your paper yesterday at the conference.
Yes.
What did you present? What was the topic?
Well, it was a very short but a very interesting topic. Last time when I was here, I presented a contemporary topic. Yesterday I presented something which think as a topic from the 16th century. Lorenz Steuer, an interesting artist from the 16th century. He was giving very interesting ideas through his woodcuts from 1567, exactly trying to communicate his idea on creativity in architecture. So as you see, it was not a historical paper, but it was a paper researching the idea of metaphor, dealing with architecture in a particular way. So that is what actually aesthetics allows people to investigate.
So it's not your first time at the conference, you said?
No,
you've been here.
This is the third time that I am here. The first time I went to the conference in 2014, mm-hmm. Then in 2016.
So how were you introduced to that?
I believe that I was introduced to Athena by some of my colleagues. They have been here, and I just got a circular email. I went to the website. It was very interesting to read about Athena. So yes, it was an intrigue to me, and I decided to come to see in person. But what you people are doing here, I'm very satisfied with what I have seen.
Okay, so can you tell me a few words about the status of the higher education system in Serbia? And what do you think are the advantages and disadvantages?
Well, in the last 15 years, there was a huge shift from a classical way of education. Belgrade University, in particular technical part, was based on the German system, classical German system of education. And then 10, 15 years ago, we shifted into this Bologna system, which is quite different from that what we had in the previous period. But we are not satisfied completely with that, because in theory, that new system should allow more flexibility, but in practice it shows some difficulties in applying exactly that freedom, that experimentation that we need, particularly in the School of Architecture. However, we are lucky that in the meantime, this few years, we have a larger shift in our staff. The older staff is going to pension, and we have lots of new people coming in with new ideas, ready to experiment, ready to think about new programs and integration of these different disciplines that we are teaching in the field of architecture. Let's say that I'm positive about that. We'll happen in the school in the next few years. Last year we were granted by Royal Institute of British Architects with the accreditation, which shows that we are close to, let's say, not perfect, but a very solid way of teaching.